Hi friends, this is Subramani from Chennai. Today I am going to explain about basic lessons. What are the basic lessons we'll cover in Delhi ERP 9? The first lesson is company creation and master creation. Once you have to start the lessons, you have to create a company. Masters means ledgers and groups and stock items. How to create ledger, how to create group, how to create stock item, how to create group. Everything, each and every lesson, I will provide a link in the below in this video. You go for description. If you go the below the video, there is one description. You can go through that. Each and every lesson I have given on separate video for lesson by lesson. So first lesson will describe you how to create a company, how to create ledgers and how to create groups and stock items, units, godowns, etc., etc. The second lesson is opening balances. How to bring opening balances in tally, that is, you have to go through the balance sheet of previous year. From that you have to take the opening balances into current year. Lesson number three is sales vouchers and purchase vouchers. In this video you will cover how to enter purchases and how to enter sales vouchers along with VAT also. Fourth lesson is sales and purchase returns. When you receive goods from your customers against sales, you have to enter in credit note. When purchase return means when you send return to your supplier, that is, you have to enter in debit note. So this lesson I have described in how to enter sales and purchase returns in tally. That is, you can go through the fourth lesson, link provided in the description. Number five is payment and receipts. Payment for actually you have to give by cash or check for expenses, salaries, rent, whatever, electricity, mobile expenses, telephone expenses, EB expenses, whatever it is, that is called payment. You have to enter in payment vouchers. Receipt means when your customers payments paid to you is called receipt. That is, you have to enter in receipt vouchers. Not only that, if you go through the bank statement, there are some credit entries like interest, and if you received any NEFT payments from your customers, you have to enter in receipt vouchers. Similarly, payment, when you paid checks or NEFT payments, you have to enter in payment vouchers. For this I have prepared a video, that is, you can go through the lesson 5 in the description below. Next, contra entry. Contra entry used for cash deposit, cash withdrawal and internal bank to bank transfers. This video also you can see, it is this video also available in the description. Next, journal entries. Journal entries you have to make for accounts adjustments. Generally it is useful for year ending on 31st March. That is, whatever the charges is payable, that is like salaries for March and rent and whatever the payable expenses that actually you will not pay in the March, you will pay in next coming year in April, so that you have to pass the journal entry, that is expenses account data to payable account. That is, you can find a video for this topic in the below description. Next, VAT calculation. What is input? What is output? Say input is a tax in your purchase invoices, is called input tax. Output VAT means is a tax mentioned in sales vouchers. That is, this output VAT you can collect from your customers. Input VAT is you have to pay to your suppliers. When your output tax is more than input tax, you have to pay the tax. If your input tax is higher than output tax, that VAT will carry forward to the next month. Next, data split. Split data. Split data is once your accounts is finalized, you can split the data into 2 years, that is for previous years and current year. Once you split the data, it will carry forward all account names, that is ledger names, stock names and closing balances to the next financial year. It's a very important, but you better to split the data after finalizing every account. Then next thing is mailing reports. How to send email reports to your customers. Then confirmation balance. This is, I will tell you how to print this confirmation letter. Go to Tally. Wait a minute. Say this is the ledger. If you want to print the confirmation balance, first I will tell you one by one steps. Display, then account books, then ledger. Go here, any ledger, print here, then click on no, select confirmation of accounts. That's it. See, this is the confirmation balance. Thank you for watching my video. I think in this I have provided here 11 lessons. These lessons will cover entire basic lessons. So for this each topic I have prepared a good video, that everything will available in the description of this video. Thank you for watching this video. Bye bye. Tata.